stumbled upon my travel diaries. I'm a traveler and explorer, and my life has led up to this. I finally decided to enter the void, and I'm taking you with me.
The void is quite nice this time of year.
Sometimes I feel lost.
But I know I have myself to guide me.
I'll never take advice from another. It would have disastrous consequences. The paranoia of manipulation would be overbearing. This is why travelers can't have friends.
Life is hard as a traveler. We already know that. It's hard for every human on this earth. And yet, for us to find solitude in defining ourselves by the things we see and the places we visit, it's so much more. There's so much anxiety induced by those around us. And sometimes, just a simple rhythm can keep us grounded.
When you're a traveler,
you begin to realize the imperfections in human language. While there's beauty in similes and metaphors,
you realize that the definitions and connotations are completely meaningless. Everyone is so blue. Why do we use that word? I know I myself am blue. And yet, because I'm a traveler, I define myself by my own definition. My favorite color is green.
So why can't I be that?
All I know is right. I know all. I am omnipotent. I am above all. And you will not degrade me.
Sometimes as a traveler, you're faced with a choice.
Sometimes you don't even know what either option means.
So you choose with your heart and your head, and you allow your decision to
forever define you.
It's lonely. Being a traveler is really lonely. That's the simplest way to put it. And the emptiness and desolation of the void really awakens the inner child in you. You feel scared and alone. And you always will.
I'm seeking a second in command to travel with me on my further adventures into the void. And maybe even become my friend. But it can be anxiety inducing. And maybe, once again, travelers are really meant to be alone. Life is really hard as a traveler. This we already know. But we can't mark ourselves as exceptions. Life is difficult for every human on this earth, or every living thing in this universe. But for those of us who define ourselves and find solitude in the places we visit and the things we see on a day-to-day basis, it's so much more. The people we meet and the moments we cherish, that's what we define ourselves by. Not by our IQs, not by our physical appearance, not even by what anyone else thinks of us. Sure, it might be lonely, but the temporary friendships we make, meeting those in our realm, is worth it. It might be scary sometimes. The world is vast and terrifying, but it's also incredible and beautiful. There are so many sights I have yet to see, and it terrifies me that I may not see them all. But it's something that I've sort of had to come to accept. I've come to accept a lot of things. I've accepted that my time here on this earth is short, so while I'm here, I'm going to see as much as I can. I may return to my roots one day, stay in touch with my family and friends, but I will never stop looking. I will continue looking for the one thing that makes me happy. I will search far and wide through the void in order to find myself and to find sanctitude in what presents itself to me. No matter where I go, however, the most important thing to remember is no matter where you go, there you are.